Hi, welcome to Dima's Stories. This is a channel meant to help students pass their exams in good grades. Alright, today I'm going to be discussing the three major genres of literature. There are still other genres of literature, but all of them fall under these three major genres. When you hear genres of literature, it simply means the classifications of literature. Alright, without much ado, let's get right into the major genres of literature. We have the prose, we have the drama, we have the poetry. Prose, drama, and poetry. Alright, prose can simply be said to mean a story that is written in everyday language and makes use of chapters and paragraphs in relating an event. Examples of prose include the novel, the autobiography, biography, essays, newspaper, and so many of them are songs that are written in everyday language and makes use of chapters and paragraphs. Drama, on the other hand, can be said to mean a story that is written in acts and scenes that employs dialogue amongst its characters. One special thing about drama is that when you're reading drama, you find out that you feel the presence of your characters. You feel the presence of your characters at that moment because of the use of dialogue. This unlike prose. When you're reading prose, you feel that you're reading an event that happened to someone in the past, or in the story of something that happened to someone in the past, which could be the author himself or another person. Let's look at the next genre of literature, poetry. Poetry can be said to mean an expression of idea or feeling through the use of stanzas and verses. One special thing about poetry is that it employs rhyme. Rhyme is very important in poetry because poetry is meant to be sung. When you have rhyme at the end of the poem, you call it end rhyme. When you have rhyme in the middle of the poem, you call it internal rhyme. Thank you for watching. If this video has been helpful, please subscribe and give it a thumb up. Thank you very much.